All right, so here's the next one. And so this one, we're going to use the distributive property here. And then we're going to bring down these two terms and we're going to combine any like terms. But when we simplify things, simplified means there's no parentheses. All right, so we want to get rid of those. And to get rid of them, we distribute the negative 3 through that expression right there. Okay, remember this means negative 3 times everything that's inside of there. And so what we do here is I'm going to do this times this, and then I'm going to do this times this. So negative 3 times 5 is the first one. The minus sign comes down. And then I do negative 3 times y. Okay? So there's that. And then this comes down, and this comes down. It is not inside those parentheses, so these terms just all come down, okay? We don't have to do anything to them. I multiplied these because they're inside the parentheses that the negative 3 is next to. This says negative 3 times all this stuff. Now, what we get here is we get negative 15. Now, the negative and the negative make a positive 3y, okay? 3 times y is just 3y. And then all of this just comes down here. So you can't do this in your head all the time. So a lot of times most of the time you just want to write things down and bring things down because it keeps it all organized for you. Now notice, I got rid of the parentheses, but now I've got to look at and see if there's any like terms. How many terms do you see? Hopefully you tell me you see 1, 2, 3, 4 terms because terms are separated by addition and subtraction signs. Okay, so we've got 4 terms. Now, which ones are alike? See how this is a number and this is a number? So those are alike. Numbers are alike. Here, these are alike because they have the same variable. They both have y's. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and look at my negative 15 and 10 here first. And there, I would get negative 15 plus 10 would give me negative 5. Okay, so you get that. Then I'm going to do this one and this one, the 3y and the 2y. Remember, just add the coefficients. I have 3y's and I add 2y's to it. So then I would get positive 5y's. What's important here is you always look at the sign that's in front of the term. Okay, that's going to help you get through it. Now, or know what, if it's positive or negative, whatever's in front, okay? So those two make 5y. This one plus this one make negative 5. These are not alike, so you just stop. That's it. It's simplified. This doesn't have a y, and this has a y. So this is a number. This is a variable with a coefficient in front of it. So that's how that one works. Okay.